Good morning, students. Welcome to Pandasar's virtual class on macroeconomics. Yesterday we discussed about investment, its meaning, and the components of investment, that is capital investment and inventory investment. Today we'll be discussing about different types of investment, that is types of investment. And here in detail we will discuss about types of investment, that is gross investment and net investment. So you can see here in the whiteboard how you can define the term gross investment. It is increase in value of capital stock during a specific period is called gross investment. Increase in the value of capital stock during a specific period of time is called gross investment. Just to make it quite simple, we can take an example. Suppose I am involved in a transportation business and I have a number of trucks. So suppose at the beginning of this year I have 10 trucks and I am doing transportation business, and over a period of time, that is during the entire next year, I increased my fleet of trucks and purchased 10 more trucks. Thus, we can say my gross investment is 10 trucks over this period, this year. Means it's over a period of time. It's not a it's not a stock concept. It's a flow concept. It can't be measured at a particular time, a particular point of time, but over a period of time. So thus, gross investment, it is investment or it is net addition to the capital stock over a period of time. Now come to the second term, that is net investment. So by definition, net investment is the actual increase in stock of capital goods during an accounting year. So in what way gross investment and net investment are different? So in gross investment, we just calculate the amount we invested, but we didn't take into account the amount or the value that we lost during the entire year due to operation of our capital goods. That we used the capital good for 1 year, and during that 1 year of use, the actual value of our capital stock of our investment has decreased. Later, we'll discuss in detail what are the reasons that the value of our investment falls. So, thus we can conclude that net investment is gross investment minus depreciation. So, yet another new term encountered, that is depreciation. So, we need to understand, in order to understand the difference between gross investment and net investment, we need to understand the term depreciation. What is depreciation? Students, in the component of investment, we have already discussed the difference between capital investment and inventory investment. That means, to make it simple, in order to produce some goods or service, we actually invest in two different types or two different ways we make our investment. That is, we purchase some capital goods and we use it again and again to produce something, and on the other hand, we invest on purchasing some raw materials, some finished, some unfinished goods, and some other things like labor, and we hire them and we accumulate them all, we integrate them all, and we produce some new goods and services. Thus, when we make investment on capital goods, say machinery, the value doesn't remain fixed for a long period of time. Suppose we purchased one ice cream making machine and we are going to use it for 10 years. So suppose at the beginning of the year when we purchased it, it cost us suppose say 1000 rupees. Then after a period of 10 years, the value of that machine will not be 1000 rupees. It will fall. And what are the reasons that the value of capital asset, the value of capital goods fall over a period of time when we make use of that capital good. So that concept is depreciation. So by definition, it refers to loss in the value of fixed asset in use on account of, so these are the reasons why the value of capital asset falls over a period of time. The first one is normal wear and tear, and you all know the reason is simply friction. So when we make use of some capital goods, there is friction, and due to friction, the value of that capital goods falls. And the second point is normal rate of accidental changes. That is, due to some circumstances, due to some situations, due to some avoidable or unavoidable situations, sometimes the value of capital goods changes. For example, suppose just to take the example of typewriters. Computer is invented and all of a sudden the value of typewriters fall drastically. So this is the second point, what it explains, normal rate of accidental changes. And the third point is expected or foreseen obsolescences. Here we are getting two different terms, that is expected obsolescence or foreseen obsolescence and unexpected or unforeseen obsolescence. So what is obsolescence? We know very well the meaning of the word expected and foreseen. Expected means something that we can expect. Foreseen means that something that we can visualize before it actually happens. But the opposite is unexpected or unforeseen. So sometimes the value of capital goods falls due to some expected reason and due to some unexpected reason. For example, normal wear and tear, it is very well expected reason. But still there are some regions where the value of capital goods fall. That is, suppose some fire accident, some theft. We cannot just expect when it is going to take place, when the fire accident will take place, when thief will come and steal away or damage, suppose mob damage. You know very well, sometimes a mob become very angry and they damage property. So it is unexpected obsolescence, and we simply cannot calculate, make a calculation of such type of obsolescences. Now, the point is that if, whether it might be our expected or unexpected obsolescence, if it is quite true that over a period of time, the value of our capital stock, our capital goods are going to fall, then a producer must have to think over it very seriously. So, what is the arrangements that a producer can do to tackle or to encounter the reduction in the value of capital asset? So, it is quite different for expected and unexpected obsolescences. Expected obsolescences, like the normal wear and tear, the producer usually makes depreciation replacement fund. To make it simple, just imagine the value of some capital goods is 1 lakh rupees, and it is expected that after 10 years the capital goods cannot be used anymore. So the life expectancy of that capital goods is 10 years, and when the producer purchased it, it cost him 1 lakh. So if you divide 1 lakh by 10, then it comes approximately 10,000 per year. So what the producer would do here is that the producer will continue to keep or maintain a depreciation replacement fund and contribute to that fund every year 10,000 rupees, so that at the end of 10 years, he would be accumulating a sum of 1 lakh rupees, and he will be in a position to purchase yet another machine to continue his production uninterrupted. Now, the other point is that what about unexpected obsolescence? That is, the reduction in the value of capital asset or capital goods due to some unforeseen reason, something that cannot be presumed, something that cannot be thought of before it actually happens. So here, the solution is making insurance of that. The producer can insure his capital goods, so that in case of any unexpected absence like fire tragedy or some theft, he can claim it from the insurance agency. Thank you.